And welcome to another, part of the mid-tier gameplay series. And today I'm gonna feature the other Japanese destroyer on tier 5, which would be the Minekaze. Well known from former times as a really good performing ship, but then got nerfed while the Kamikaze R, Fujin, and so on stayed like they are. And are still considered very overpowered, while the Minekaze got some nerfs in and is not to be considered overpowered anymore. So, the Minekaze is, and on tier 5, the Japanese destroyer lines part into two trees, and the Minekaze is the first one of the tree tech tree that ends up in the Harugumo. So it's considered to be in the Japanese gunboat line, so to call, say. And yeah, you will find out really quickly because it has four guns that are actually usable and compared to the poor two guns of the Mutsuki, or Mutsuki, as someone corrected me, it's called Mutsuki. So the Minekaze is and therefore a bit more usable in my opinion. It also has these three double torp launcher that reload really quickly, so they didn't change that, but they changed the speed of the torpedoes, so it got significantly nerfed, and I think it's not really at a high speed right now, and I think they are detected also from the moon. So as you see right now, you can actually use these guns. So we have a tier 4 destroyer, the Chenyang, Pan-Asian. And even though I have a bad reload on the guns, that doesn't matter. Since, I can smoke up comfortably here against Chenyang, since his torps can't hit me. If you look at the matchup, it's more or less the worst possible matchup. The upside is it's only tier 5 and tier 4. The downside is a lot of cruisers, some destroyers, but two carriers. So this is a game, or normally these games are decided by the carriers, and there's little I can do about it. But as I stated, the Minekaze is at least able to take a fight with some DDs if you play it smart. You also have this good alpha damage on the guns that allows you to chunk down enemy destroyers over time, but just by well placed and well timed salvos. So in this regard, the Minekaze is in this superior towards the that's definitely the case. So, quickly over the situation, we are all sitting here in the cap. Now it's gonna be a bit more dangerous for me, since the Minekaze was spotted, the enemy one, who can also spam torps into my smoke. So I'm alerted by that and angling myself towards him already. And there we go. Torpedoes. I hope I'll be able to... just at the moment I reversed back, and he exposed himself really in the open, which is not the smart move and probably gets punished. But you see the alpha damage. If you hit your guns, it hurts. And the Königsberg finished the Minekaze off. So that threat is gone. The Shenyang seems to have left the... he left the cap. So I can just comfortably sit in here and cap the cap in smoke. Now my goal is to provide some vision to for my team. It's always recommended. And what you can do in the Minekaze is you can just spam torps. That's your main or big advantage, I would say. I'm just, since there are so many cruisers, which are really always on the move and waiting a lot, it's hard to hit torpedoes, so I'm just guesstimate or like put preemptive torps left, right, and center, since I can spam them and it doesn't cost me much. I try to hit the Yubari here, and seems as if I get successful with at least one torpedo. Yes. Didn't do too much damage, but still always, or is often inflicting a flooding. But since it's cruiser, as I said, worst possible matchup. Not much I can do here. When it comes to concealment, the Mutsuki sits on 6 kilometers without concealment expert and 5.4 with concealment expert. So exactly the same values as the Kamikaze and other clones, and also as the Mutsuki. This is a big upset. So if you have a 10-point captain already on tier 5, then you have a big advantage because you can outspot every other enemy destroyer. Yeah, and provide a lot of spotting for your team. And that's basically what you should do in the Japanese destroyers. More in the Mutsuki, because it has so pitiful gun damage. As I said, in the Minakaze you are able to do certain or pull something off, especially with your alpha damage. You can play a bit more aggressive if you have your smoke available to run into cover or to get undetected really quick if need be. By the way, these torps were just guesstimation torps. I expected the Shenyanya maybe towards going towards A again, but he sadly didn't. Yeah, and as I said, I'm just spamming the torps. Never mind, this is really not a big issue for me, since they are so wayable, and I just want to have, I just want a spot for my team here. Intercept maybe DDs. Also make sure that I have my guns on the right side where I expect the enemy, so the Shenyang was spotted up there last time. So if he comes back again in, like he does here, I have my guns available. But I'm not really tempted to shoot right now, since there is a Königsberg really, really close to me. And I want to go out of the detection range. Throwing some torps also in this corner again. Maybe he stops, has to turn in. As I said, it's really hard to hit cruisers with these torps, even though there's quite fast reloading. But the thing is more that cruisers are waiting a lot. So Minakaze, yeah, okay, here you get really lucky, because that guy crowned it into the island, and yeah, he's eating 1, 2, 3 torps, and that's the end of him. Also, now I know where the Shenyang went, since he smoked up there. Spamming, of course, torps in there, and I can still safely sit in here. Issue is, I don't know what's coming, so I'm peeking out again. And that are Königsberg torps that might have range, so I have to be aware of that. And the Karlsruhe was also approaching the cap right now, and yeah, therefore I'm forced to leave. I can't reverse back into my smoke, since I would eat a ton of damage. I call this target out for my team, so they deal with it. And Shenyang gets 3 shots on me, which I didn't calculate it in. But now I should be fine for the moment, I guess. But this Karlsruhe is still pushing in, which is a bit of an issue for me. I use my repair to fix the rudder so I can accelerate away quicker and hope that I don't get fire set on my ship. And just when I say it, that just happened, that increases my spotting range to almost 8 kilometers, which is bad for me, so I have to actively dodge here. You see my wiggling, always waiting for the salvos to arrive. Slowing down now to make him overshoot me. Works kind of, not as successful as I would have liked to, but... So now the smoke ran out, but I lost unnecessarily some HP. That was on me because I didn't accelerate fast enough away, and Definitely not the fault of my team or so. That was just me being a bit too careless and hoping that the Karlsruhe is getting killed quicker. And yeah. Now the Shenyang is spotted again. I'm again going now for an engagement since he's low HP. I have my smoke almost available. And yeah, dodged most of the shells. Maybe a little word about the AA. It's garbage, but I guess you assumed that already. Japanese ships are never known for being such AA monsters, so yeah. Throwing some torps into the general direction where I spotted the Shenyang last, I also aimed one set behind the last spotted position just because of that he is. How can I say it? Maybe reversing in the smoke. So I always assume that. Normally the people tend to not sit in one place. And I hit two torps on the Königsberg that was running behind that smoke. And yeah, he got a flooding because he repaired my single fire. A thing I never can recommend for how can I say it? Never can recommend for yeah, cruisers, unless it's really necessary, but then you have to be on really low HP. So trying to finish off the Shenyang here. I'm able to. I sneaked into my smoke and then suddenly my detection range goes down, which is great for me. But someone knocked out my, well, killed one of my torp launchers, so I have only two available. I expect the Yubari to use this cover in front of the island, so I send some torps this way. Yeah, but right now it doesn't look too good for us. They managed to get the control over A, and I hope for the Orion, my only battleship here, to be able to pull something off here, because otherwise it doesn't look too good. Our Isokaze is playing around with the Orion here instead of going for the cap, which is never a good thing. We are one cap behind, and yeah, that can end up badly. If that Yubari gets killed, I have a good chance of getting into A and recap it. But it doesn't look as if my Orion has shots on him since he's using this cover of the island here. Or the Yubari is using the cover and he's occupied with the Kirov and with the carrier. So I assume, okay, I maybe have to go to the other side where my Isokaze managed to get killed for whatever reason. Completely unnecessary, but we all know how it is, right? It's low tier, many unexperienced players, and therefore I'm not pissed about it or something like that, because I imagine that things like this happen, and yeah, it's really hard for me to carry this game. I can just only rely on the Orion that he kills off the cruisers, because sooner or later he gets killed by the carriers, and I hope that my carriers are finishing off the Orion, so I can hunt the enemy carriers. That's the only play I have left, besides capping one cap. As soon as the Orion goes down, we have a real, real big issue. And of course the carriers have still planes in the air, and it looks as if my Suyu doesn't have any planes anymore left, and my Hosho doesn't have a fighter left. So if you check that, maybe because of the Langley fighters are so much stronger than the Japanese, especially upgraded, so I guess that's what happened, since I see a full HP squad from the enemy Suyu. It's probably not really contested by our carriers, or you never know, when the people are grinding, then probably Zuyo had no upgraded fighters or something like that. Could be. And our Orion goes down, which makes it even worse for me, and yeah. Okay, the Orion is spotted. I'm sending torps really quick there. And yeah. Now it's I'm in a pickle again. What to do? Hope the carrier isn't coming for me. I need to go and bring this island here between me and the Orion so he can't shoot me. I'm confident that I can torp dodge, but it seems as if the carriers are going for something different, which is good for me. And if he would have had more time, I think I could, or time-wise, by points. So, but right now we are so far behind in points, and I can't go B since there is the Yubari somewhere, and I'm in a real pickle, and I can't get any help from my team anymore. And of course, my A won't shoot down any planes, so this is the most certain loss. Try to think about if I did forget something about the Minakaze. Well, I have to say, it's not a bad ship, absolutely not. It does fine in tier 5, especially when you have the right matchmaking means. Not so many DDs, a lot of battleships, not so many cruisers. And of course, the best case scenario is if there is no carrier around. Because then you can be, after capping or getting control over cap, just be a nuisance in the flank of the battleships or top the enemy. Just by being in the absolute unexpected position. A good DD player is never spotted, but it's unavoidable in this case. I mean, if you have the Minakaze is, as I said, also somewhat able to fight enemy destroyers if you do it smart. Means you use your alpha damage, make sure that your shells hit, and you don't go over long drawn fights. You don't engage Nicholas that is full HP unless you have a smoke available, for example. You just light up targets for your enemy and for your team so they can shoot at them. And this is the Japanese line just suffers from at least when they are really torpedo related like the Mutsuki, from getting almost no XP from just spotting enemy ships, because that's what the thing what the Mutsuki or the Japanese destroyers in general are better than other nations DDs, because other nations DDs they can't play on the flanks or shouldn't play on the flanks because they don't have the torps and have to be more central, have to smoke up and utilize their guns more. That's the thing that the Japanese destroyers aren't as good at, and which is okay in my opinion, but XP wise it can like differ a lot. You can be the best player of the world, but if the matchup isn't working out for you, then there's nothing you can do about it. I mean, if you don't hit your torps or the enemy ships or players are aware that you are torping them or are good at dodging, then you have a hard time in the Minakaze. Yeah. That's it basically about the Minakaze, I would say. After the nerf. Before the nerf, this ship was straight overpowered like the Kamikaze and other clones or other Minakaze clones are. Right now it's, I think, balanced, and there's the only thing you can hope is having a good matchup, I think. It's, I think, also doing quite okay against tier 6 and tier 7s if you know to play around tier 7 radars or certain ships, but it doesn't have the influence than it had before. And of course you don't want to have carriers in the game, but that's a different story. Alright, so not the most damaged, but wasn't really able to do something, because fighting yourself through the cruiser line with carriers above, no way that you reach any battleship, because they tend to stay a bit behind the cruisers normally. So I'm quite happy that I killed two cruisers and on top of DD, which is, I mean, I think I did my fair share of damage here. And that was really necessary, I guess. But I couldn't turn it around. The matchmaking was simply not favorable enough for me. And it looks as if the enemy saw you knew what he was doing. And yeah. I mean, 1.1k base XP as top tier in a loss tells you also the story. My team was not really the best at it, but as I said, nothing can do it. Many unexperienced players, many new players. So there's no one. I never blame the people normally on tier 5 or so, unless it's really obvious that they could have done something better, even with limited knowledge about the game. Yeah, detailed overview. Most of the damage comes, of course, from the torpedoes, but 10k with 24 shell hits tells you also the story. Means your alpha damage can be quite devastating. You have a good fire chance, so you can also set ships on fire, which I capitalized on the Königsberg, I guess, who ran into my torps after damage conning one fire. So, yeah, you can play around, and I think it Minikaze is definitely in a good state. And could be also a lot of fun to play for most all of you who didn't grind the line yet. And of course, with the Hatsuharu, Shiratsuyu, there are coming some other ships in the gunboat line. But after that, Akizuki, Kitakaze, Harugumo, that's definitely also a good line to play. Definitely enjoyable to play for the people that like we call it, Daka Daka. Alright, boys and girls. Hope you liked that video. Hope it helped you out if you're grinding or want to grind this line. All the important facts I said, I guess. And so if you liked it, give it a like. Always appreciate it. If you're not subscribed to the channel yet and you think about, yeah man, that guy has good content, why not? Then I always appreciate that. Other than that, have a nice day and see you next time. Bye bye.